Yes, sir. Please start, sir.
Good afternoon, dear organization and respected VC of Bihar Agricultural University and other co-worker with organization. A very good afternoon to all of you, and I say special thanks to the organization for giving this opportunity to deliver lecture on this issue. Today I'm going to deliver lecture on how we can explore vegetables as functional food for fighting against COVID pandemic. Remember the early of this year 2020, the news were crowded with COVID information, and everyone getting that information that some virus is coming which is dangerous and may kill many of people. Although the virus nature, that is coronavirus, was earlier detected, but this virus is very specific and new. Specificity is totally rely on very rapid spread and some specific immune response which were not found earlier. And after 3 and 4 months, scientists were puzzling to understand what is happening in our system. And after rigorous research, they found there is something deformity or defectivity in our immune response, and as a result, COVID patient dies. At the same time, if WHO and other scientists throughout the world, they suggested go for nutrition-rich food to get prevention from this problem. So, at first, we have to know how it is happening, what COVID is doing to our lungs. First, if you see the left side, this is the virus. It comes through our lungs through inhalation, and it destroys our lung cell by interacting with ACE receptor. After that, when it comes and when it destroys the alveolar cell, it release some of the toxin and some of the ATP, which causes pyrotoxis, which lead to get information by this alveolar macrophages, epithelial cell, and endothelial layer. They got this information, and this lead to release of some certain type of cytokines. For 2 to 3 months, there is a lot of news that in these disease, a cytokine storm create problem in the lungs, and it causes death for some person, but some people also survive. So what happened when it gives the signal, that signal molecule cytokine, it gives the positive feedback to T cell, monocyte, and macrophage. These are our innate immune system. Some are immune. So what happens when this immune gets feedback? It works in two directions. In one direction, people who have defective immune system, their cells produce a huge cytokine storm, which causes a huge rapid inflammation. As a result of high inflammation, localized cell damages and it lead to multi-organ failure. In a healthy immune system, what happens? It triggers specific cell which bind with this virus and it help to killer cell. Killer cell is a, one of the important part of our innate immune system. It interact and it destroy. And it also destroy the that infected cell. This is the infected cell. So our immune system selectively identify it and destroy this affected system, and there will be a minor inflammation in our lungs and can be survived. So this is the main role. And during these findings for last three and four months that happened from onward January, scientists understand there is some problem in immunity. And earlier also people understand there is some nutritive substances which interact with our innate immunity and it function to enhance our immune function. First thing we must know, though, what are the nutritional compound which protect our immunity. For last few months, we are on that people are saying immune boosting. That term, I never found any scientific journal. Immune boosting, it should be better how we can manage our innate immunity. Because this all these nutrients, they maintain our immune system. So our immune system correctly work and prevent the virus infection. So what it has been observed that physiology of our immune system highly influenced by many nutritional compounds. Some are vitamins like ascorbic acid, vitamin D, vitamin E, some minerals, particularly zinc. And some mineral also work like copper, selenium. Another important compound is probiotics. That is gut microbiota. They also help to fight against immune-related problem. So here our observation could be whether we shall take this nutritional compound as preventive measure or curative measure. So far, there's some of the research which scientists are trying to infuse various vitamins, particularly vitamin C and vitamin D and zinc, along with other medicine to as a curative measure, but result is not good for immunocompressive person, immunocompromised person, like who has the risk, they are facing problem, but who are healthy, they are not facing problem. So if you give these vitamins and minerals as nutritional therapy, so it acts as preventive measure, very little extent curative measure. Now you can see here how these vitamin D, E, zinc, polyunsaturated fatty acid, probiotics, phenolics act on our immune cell. In left side, this is the left side, these cells are our innate immune system. When your virus come to your body, that's first. Neutrophil, monocyte, dendritic cell and NK cell. Here, the very important thing is that this monocyte macrophage, they play a great role because they engulf the virus and destroy it. So if you see here, the vitamin D play main role, that chemotaxis, phagocytosis. So another is plant phenolics also, and probiotics, they help in increase the monocyte macrophages, which help to phagocytosis pathogen. Another thing is that NK cell, they are the natural killer cell. They are the major killer cell which directly kill the entered virus. So if you see here, mostly gene and probiotics, they have major role to destroy the virus. So it is our innate that already we have immune system. It is our immune system, and it play a major role, and it affect our it affect on our lungs, and it can prevent this process. And these two are adaptive immune system, that is T cell and B cell. It affect after virus enter our body, and after when a outside component enter our body, then virus as a outside body, when enter, this cell got some signal and they produce some antibodies. So antigen, virus enter as antigen, and this cell produce some antibody, and they selectively kill or bind with viral protein and destroy it. So it also observed that these all these nutrient compounds, they have some role in inflammation marker. If you see here, if you read properly, this inflammation marker, they have main role in this disease. And if you use this nutrition rich compound, it enhance T cell activity and it selectively kill the virus. Now during thorough research, I have found some of the strategies as nutritional supplement, vitamin C, vitamin C plus zinc, or even vitamin D in some of the countries like France, Spain, USA, in China also, they have started, and they have they are doing, but detailed report still not came. They are telling it reduces inflammation and acute condition, but details report still are not available. Now before going to details discussion, we have to think, so what the role of vegetables? Vegetables also contain various nutrient. What we observe here, that is vitamin D, vitamin E, like this way, different compound also present our vegetable. So whether we can take vegetables as nutrition therapy or preventive measure, how it work really or not, we have to discuss in next slide. First we come into vitamin B complex. Vitamin B complex are water soluble one. Everybody, you know that. And vitamin B complex have many vitamins, at least 8 vitamins are there. Among them, B12, for vitamin B12, there's no plant source. Very few algae produce vitamin B12. It only available in non-vegetarian source. So except vitamin B12, other vitamin B complex is available plenty in vegetables. So before coming to vegetables, I want to discuss how they are active, how they are working. If you see that vitamin B2 and B3, they totally, first they prevent viral replication. Another, that cytokine storm, which is the major problem in COVID, which is prevented by vitamin B3 and vitamin B. Vitamin B6 also prevents cytokine storm. Another important problem is viral binding and invasion. You must know that viral binding, it happen because virus bind with ACE2 angiotensin receptor and some other component. So when it bind, then it only affect. So it has been observed that some of the compound like vitamin B9, they prevent viral binding. Another thing that most important vitamins here is vitamin B1. Vitamin B1 is, you know, everybody, is a thiamine and very crucial vitamin, and it is important for adaptive immunity. Means you have to develop that the, when your vaccine come and vaccine give your immunity to, so what it happen, it gives a memory to T cell and T cell. So definitely in this case of the better activity, vitamin B1 is essential. Now we will see what are the vitamins B complex available in vegetables. If you see here, vitamins, all vitamins, they are available in all vegetables, but it has been observed many of they are very good sorts of vitamins, and you see that is B9 or folic acid, they are good source in leafy vegetables and some of the other crops. But must remember, when you go for taking these vegetables for health benefit, they should be thermally stable, because if you go that vitamin B1 and vitamin B9, the total folate is not very thermostable. So when you go for cooking, it will loss. So we have to see that how we can. Hello. Hello. Sorry. Hello. Yes. What happened? When we give any cooking process or any processing, the vitamin is affected by various processing condition like temperature, light, all that. Likewise, some of the crops also affected by freezing process or canning process. Now we'll look after this matter. So when we select any vegetable, whether it gives immunity, first we have to think for whether our vitamin can be retained our body. How it is affected by method of cooking or storage or freezing or canning. So these are the two processing for long time we can go for this processing, how it affect and how this cooking affect, we have to see very carefully. If you see the nature of the vitamins, vitamin B1 and folic acid is highly thermolabile compound. So when you go for any boiling or steaming, any cooking, it will loss a very large quantity. Since they are water soluble vitamins, so during boiling with water, some of the vitamins come with also boiled water. So you always be remember, when you go for boiling of vegetables, don't throw the vegetables as such, rather you use that boiled water for cooking of other commodities, because it contains lot of soluble vitamins, water soluble vitamins. In comparison to boiling, it has been observed that pressure cooking and steaming retain much of the thermolabile vitamins, because this dry heat not lost too much of your vitamin, water soluble vitamin, which are thermolabile. Similarly, storage, lot of the vitamins, particularly who are not thermostable, like vitamin C, vitamin B complex, B1, B9, they are lost gradually. Freezing process reduce the space of loss, but canning, again, it is a very high temperature process, and during the canning process, most of the thermosensitive vitamin goes to loss. Now we will look that another vitamin, that is vitamin D, they have much role rather than other vitamin. During last 3 and 4 months, when we were searching, we found that vitamin D make a better role our innate immunity. If you see the innate immunity, it direct have role in suppression of inflammation form. So when a inflammation storm develop inside the lungs, it rapidly destroy. Particularly, it have main role in monocyte and macrophage. Because macrophage, they have the primary role to engulf the virus. And it is directly depend on vitamin D. Earlier also, many research has found that other virus also can be controlled by proper vitamin D level inside our body. In adaptive immunity, it also helps many ways. Particularly, if you see here that B cell and T cell, it totally depend on vitamin D3 for their main activity. Now, very interesting thing is that whether we can get the vitamin D from vegetables. Actual what vitamin D is effective, most effective vitamin D is vitamin D3, which not avail any vegetables. Because any plant do not contain vitamin D3. Rather, plant contain argocalciferol, that is vitamin D2. It has been observed that mostly mushroom, they are very high source for vitamin D2. Besides this, sesame seed, many times we use as vegetable, sesamum seed. It is also consumed as auspicious food. It contains very good quantity of vitamin D2. Besides this, tomato, lettuce finger also contain vitamin D2. Now, what is the active form of vitamin D? Actually, we do not need to take vitamin D if we expose to sun. Everybody know when we expose to sufficient sun, our skin able to translate the inherent cholesterol into vitamin D3, that is cholecalciferol. Interestingly, what happened during the COVID time, people mostly stay inside the house. It may be because of panic or maybe because of office closes. Most of the work we have done from our work. So very little chance was there to expose. As a result, last 4 and 5 months, there are increased number of vitamin D deficient patient. Even if you go to any shop, you can find this demand has increased. So in this condition, you remember that vitamin D, if we not properly exposed to sun, we can't get vitamin D3 if we can't take other source. Now, for vitamin D3, there is no plant source, but there are some animal source. So who are non-vegetarian or omnivorous, they have their upper hand because some of the food like egg yolk, fish oil, they are very good source of vitamin D3. And you remember among fish, sea fish is a good source of vitamin D3. But it is very less available in inland fish. So always better to go for sea fish to have the dietary vitamin D3. Except this, some of the red meat contain good quantity of vitamin D3. Red meat liver also contain good quantity of vitamin D3. Another research now we are finding, if your hen exposed throughout the day in sun, the vitamin D3 content of egg yolk also has increased. So there is this possibility where nature reared hen, it contains very good form of vitamin D3, that is cholecalciferol. And another is that you have earlier seen that in the right side, this right side we have argocalciferol, that is vitamin D3. Now, what happens when both of these through diet or UV light? it goes to first liver. Now it in liver it transform to 25 hydroxy cholecalciferol. Now this cholecalciferol for this dietary non-veg source and UV light, it form to 5 dihydroxy vitamin D3, but when argocalciferol is goes, it create vitamin that calcidiol D2, and for this source it produce calcidiol D3. Again, one step is necessary. When it goes to kidney, it produces different compound. Among these, that calcitriol is very active form, and other dihydroxy vitamin D, this is not active form, and this active form is uptake by vitamin D receptor in our body. So there are many receptor in our body, vitamin D receptor, it linked with calcitriol and it get absorbed. So too long I am speaking this active form of metabolism. Why? Because you first know there is some plant vitamin D, that is phyto vitamin D or argocalciferol. They also converted to calcitriol, but their conversion is very low and they are poor binding to vitamin D receptor. So if we take sufficient quantity of vitamin D2 from mushroom, because nowadays in Bihar also and throughout the India, people are using high quantity of mushroom. Mushroom is very good source of vitamin D2, but although it contain high amount of vitamin D2, it have poor binding to vitamin D receptor, so it effect is very much less. Modern day, if you buying any vitamin D, you must see the label, because some of the company, they are producing argocalciferol, that is vitamin D2 capsule. How they are producing? They are just producing mushroom under the ultraviolet to formation of cholecalciferol or argocalciferol. So ultraviolet, under ultraviolet ray, that mushroom produces these vitamins and it has very good health benefit. But you must remember the bioavailability of vitamin D2 is much poor compared to vitamin D3. So don't be worried. This is, although this slide is not for our conference related, but for general information, this pandemic, better you every day go for sun bath, very simple, at least 11 to 2 o'clock, 15 minutes, 10 minutes exposure to sun is sufficient to form your vitamin D3 in your body. Beside this, who are non-vegetarian can go for egg yolk or sea fish. Even there are supplements. There are very good supplements of calcium along with vitamin D3. Now, another important vitamins used in this pandemic as a trial is vitamin C. And we have found they have direct role in neutrophil function, macrophage function and natural killer, that is innate immunity. So in innate immunity, it have direct role, and I have found that when you suspect for doctor always tell that you take one Mosambi or one Sandra. Why? Because this, you know that vitamin C rich fruits like sandra or orange give sufficient quantity of vitamin C and it keeps immunity. So how it work? It improve the condition of innate immunity, and particularly it also observed recently in other viral diseases, that is dengue. For dengue, it has been observed that if you take a good quantity of kiwi fruit, your chances of
Sir, please unmute, sir. Please unmute yourself, sir. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, now it is okay.
Something happened?
Yes, yes, sir. Now it is okay. Please share the presentation.
Sorry for disturbance. Now that ascorbic acid for what we I was saying that for healing it happened, it improve our innate immunity. As a result, the killer cell activity also increase.
Excuse me, sir. Sorry for the interruption. Please share your slides, sir.
Now it is okay.
Yes, sir. It is now opening. Yes, sir. Just blow it and start now.
Now, if you find here that vitamin C improve your innate immunity and also help to adaptive immunity function, because again the concept is coming that when your vaccine will come, you have to have very good quantity of vitamin C for your B lymphocyte and T lymphocyte function. And earlier also there are few documents that when vaccination comes and if you take proper vitamin C rich food, then that is effectivity of the vaccine will increase. Now,
I think we are having a little bit of technical issues. Please be patient.
Please, No, okay.
Please share the problem happened.
Yes, sir. Please share the presentation.
Okay. Is it okay?
Sir, please share the presentation, sir. Slides, sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. It's coming.
Now, when we think for vitamin C, you always feel that this will be amlaki or amla or orange or guava. But you must remember that there are some of the source in vegetables also. But like that very leafy vegetable, cauliflower and capsicum, they are very good source of vitamin C. But problem here is that our vitamin C or ascorbic acid highly thermolabile. They got destroyed by high temperature. So how we can get vitamin C? Because there are a lot of desert vegetables, like our cucurbit, so many desert vegetables are there. They are, we are using as a raw food. So we can use they as source of vitamin C. And there is some thing is the salad. In foreign country, they use salad vegetables for very good source of vitamin C, as well as some dietary fiber, good fiber, which improve the health of your probiotics. But in Indian context, we generally not for that green leafy salad. Rather, our salad is that is your cucumber, mooli, gajar, so carrot and radish, and these are although good in nutrient, but root part of the vegetables do not contain very good quantity of vitamin C. But there is a scope in for cucumber, which we can increase the vitamin C content to selectively. And interesting thing is that there are some also work is going on in our India, where the people are increasing not only vitamin C, vitamin B, vitamin A also, that is beta carotene rich cucumber, which is attractiveness for your salad disease. And fortunately, I was associated with this crop during the germplasm collection and evaluation. It was I was in at IIVR, Indian Institute of Vegetable Research, and there Dr. Prabhakar Ranjan, she was collected this orange flesh cucumber, and recently we got registered this germplasm. So next stage we are she is doing that how we can transfer this character to our most of the commercial viable variety. So if we transfer this character, that is vitamin A, beta carotene rich, so it gives attractiveness to present day cucumber. And obviously in next time we also think to increase the vitamin C content of this variety. Now, hello. Hello, Solanki.
Yes, sir. You are audible,
hello.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Some people are raising hand. Are there any issue?
No, sir. I think previous issue might have been there, sir. No issues, sir.
Okay, actually it is better to complete my lecture, after that we will discuss. Some in my screen,
yes,
there is a really lot of hands coming. People are raising their hands.
Okay, sir, let's complete our lecture first. Uske baad, after that only we will come to the discussion part. Interaction part will be thereafter.
So another thing I have told earlier, that desert vegetables, particularly cucurbits, you know that muskmelon, watermelon, and long melon, they have lot of scope in this regard, because they are eaten as raw, and definitely as they are fruit part, definitely it contain very good quantity of vitamin C. Generally, vitamin C have tendency to source to sink, because whether it produce in leaves, but it generally accumulate inside the fruits. And Indian also prefer that tomato as salad. So these are the crops where our desert vegetables where we can use. And you must remember, in this connection we can next winter, although there will be very less scope for cucurbits, but for there is very good scope in next winter. And tomato, there are many germplasm is available in our India, and people are doing a lot of research for their vitamin C content. And particularly pimpinifolium was found as a very good source of vitamin C. So people are trying to translate this character to our cultivated tomato. And as a breeder, many people can find this as a source of vitamin C. Our future program to how to increase the vitamin C content in tomato. So we use the tomato as a salad crops. Besides this, another thing, nowadays one trend is coming, that is vitamin A-rich tomato, that is yellow color or orange color tomato. They are also give the attractiveness to our diet, and along with we have to think for the vitamin C also. Now, regarding this muskmelon, I want to share one of my experience. So during IIVR, Indian Institute of Vegetable Research, when I was screening more than 100 vegetables, we have found this orange muskmelon, they have content, their specific activity was many higher. We are doing antioxidant activity using various methods, and we have found the vitamin Q prime value was very much higher compared to other activity. So we thoroughly searched, and we found that okay, there is some problem. And it actually, what happened, it contained very good quantity of vitamin C, and vitamins, because of high vitamin C, it gives very good result. So when in next summer, not possible now, but next summer, always try to take good quantity of muskmelon. It enhances your boost your immunity. Another concept is coming, that is mycogen. During Indian Institute of Vegetable Research, I have done some of the work on mycogen. one of the who is present here in this conference, that is Dr. Lalu Prasad Jadhav. He was our my student, and that time we studied the mycogenes, because mycogenes generally consume as fish. So whether what is the content of vitamin C inside the mycogenes, and we select some Indian vegetables. Indian vegetables among these, whether it is suitable or not suitably, we studied the suitability, and we found that amaranthus and water spinach, they are the very good candidate, and even radish was a good candidate for mycogen. Here we found that if you see this radish, when mycogen contain very high quantity of vitamin C. In our India, the radish leaves are used mature, not mature, semi-mature radish leaves used as a leafy vegetable. So if we think for radish as a source of mycogen, and we explore the radish as mycogen, and then radish will be the very good portion for vitamin C. Similarly, that amaranthus, they are also found in for three cases, all cases, the amaranthus, they are vitamin C is higher in my that mature part, and although they are mature, but one thing must remember that because of tenderness, amaranthus might be very tender, and they are high bioavailable. Although there is not much to good trend, but here the quantity is sufficient for your body immunity. And in our country, that mycogen is not our still day fashion, because people don't like mycogen as because we generally not fresh eat fresh fruit, we generally cook. But nowadays in hotel industry, restaurant, they are seeking for garnish the dishes with mycogens. And in very Mumbai now phenugreek mycogens also gaining popularity. Mycogen can be a good option for vitamin C. Now, among all these things, so we understand the vitamins have lot of role in boosting the immunity. Similarly, some of the minerals, they have. If you see here, that vitamin that zinc, what it happened, it helps to mucilage clearance. When before attacking, it helps to remove the virus, and it prevents replication. Antiviral immunity, that is that innate immunity, it helps to enhance the innate immunity. Another is that inflammation storm, cytokine storm, what happened, it prevents this. So anti-inflammatory property, because of it has some anti-inflammatory property, so it helps to prevent inflammation, and definitely bacterial homeostasis, and like that what happened inside the pneumonia, if that co-infection started, it feels also that co-infection problem. So definitely if you are high risk person, if you have comorbidities, definitely zinc deficiency is a very risk factor. Although if you take sufficient quantity of zinc in your food, so it helps to boost your immunity. And nowadays, if you go to shop, even doctor also giving zinc syrup. Instead of taking zinc syrup, you can go for various vitamins, various vegetables. We have observed that leafy vegetables and legumes, they are very good. All kind of legume and leafy vegetables, they are very rich source compared to other food. But here some of the problem is there, that zinc absorption is a major issue in our India. Our Indian soil is not deficient in zinc. So zinc content of our any diet, that is either maybe a cereal or maybe a vegetables or maybe a pulse, they are very rich in vitamin that is zinc. But problem is that our the bioavailability zinc reduce in our condition. Why? Because most of the cases we take the cereal which rich in phytic acid. So definitely when phytic acid will be there in your zinc, and it make it bio non-available. Not only zinc, calcium, magnesium, all will be bioavailable. Those who are double cation charge, they are interact with phytic acid or oxalate or inositol pyrophosphate, polyphosphate. So definitely it reduces its availability. Another issue is the storage depth. During storage, zinc reduce. Even baking process. Although baking process, brinjal we baked sometimes, but in general, baking process reduce the bioavailability of zinc. And you must remember how to increase the zinc bioavailability in our diet. So when you take zinc as a nutritional source, you have to take good quantity of vitamin C along with that. And definitely when better to take vegetables and fruits along with other nutrients. So vitamin C help to enhance its absorption. Another is the blanching or cooking process. It has been observed during cooking that zinc in the food is slowly released from the food matrix, and it helps bioavailability. Similarly, freezing process also enhance some conditions. In some conditions, freezing frozen vegetables are very good source of zinc. Now, another specific condition in this COVID is microbiome dysbiosis. Till now, we are telling only the nutritive substances. Now, we are going to another dimension of our life, that is microbiome, a living organism, how it helps to modulate any infection. Actually, there is a one axis, that is brain, lungs, gut, microbiome axis. Actually, what happened in our gut, at least 10 to the power 14 microbes stay. There are many kinds of bacteria, bifidobacteria, lactobacillus, many type of bacteria they harbor, and they shelter in our intestine. They use our food, and alternatively, what they do, they give some of the good thing to us. They produce a short chain fatty acid that helps to that act as a neurotransmitter. So our nerve function, our neurological function is directly linked with microbiome, that microbiota present in our gut. Another things they do, they prevent our system from abnormal infection. If any pathogenic bacteria enter our system, they make a homeostasis with that, and they kill that pathogenic microorganism. They don't allow to increase their population. And many way they have direct role in infection. Recent time, very recently, I think 1 and 2 months before, that we identified that angiotensin receptor, it not only present in lungs, but also it present in our intestine. So what happened? If by chance your bacteria goes into, the virus goes into stomach, it can bind to your stomach. People, those who do not have a good immunity, or those people, those who do not have very good balance of microbiome, for them, this bacteria, the virus easily bind with this receptor. You see here, this is the receptor, angiotensin receptor. Here, this virus bound, and it creates some other problem. What problem? That all same problem happens in lungs. And why it happened? Because if your microbiome is not working properly, so first thing that, if your microbiome is not working properly, it lead to some problem, and as a result, you find that some of the patients are suffering from diarrhea or dysentery type of symptom. So early phase, your microbiome play a good role. If your microbiome is not very good, if you are taking many time antibiotics, your microbiome will be disturbed. If you are taking not healthy food, your microbiome will be disturbed. Even it recently it has been found that glyphosate, one of the pesticide, when people using glyphosate containing pesticide, their stomach composition, that is microbiota composition inside the intestine, has totally changed. As a result, their metabolite production is also different. So definitely your lifestyle, your food habit, your many things, it affect your microbiome, and microbiome dysbiosis happen, and it lead to increase the entrance of other pathogen like virus. Then definitely when it increase the infection with this virus, it directly link, it have directly link to lungs, because when inflammation started, this inflammatory marker also trigger the inflammation inside your lungs. So there are two way process that your lungs gives information to your intestine, and intestine also can give to lungs. So those people who have very good healthy microbiome, their chance of infection will gradually reduce. But those who are have some problem in microbiome dysbiosis, they are very prone to this virus. Now I am telling one of the very interesting things in next, that if you see that in our life, we would take food for our years, that is totally determine our life's long health. Because if we take a good food during first 3 years, it help to develop your good microbiome inside your stomach. But now what is happening, people are rich, they are giving very instant formula, they are not taking care of our inherent food. So what happened, that our children are getting food which are contaminated. It gives a new kind of environment for our gut microbiota. When our baby is growing, they will not get such kind of food in a environment. As a result, their microbiota will differently. So very important that daily, at the time of daily, maternal microbes like play. And infant diet is very much important. You see that infant diet, because selective substrate, what you take, it gives a lifelong process, and it retains the memory for your immunity. Another is that antibiotics. Nowadays, people have very, very bad thing that without any discussing, some stomach problem is there. Take antibiotics, and like this way, what is happening? It, when antibiotics kill a pathogen, it also kill your microbiome pathogen. Microbiome, that is beneficial bacteria. So if beneficial bacteria will also kill. And you must remember, when you take too much antibiotics, drop vitamins. Why? Because your intestine microbiota also produce that kind of vitamins. So when you use antibiotics, it destroy the capacity of microbes to produce vitamins, and they will reach out from your intestine. It affects your future activity. Another is probiotics. In India, fortunately, we use fermented food. Throughout the India, in southern part of the India, rice based fermented food. Northern belt, we use many kind of pickle. Pickle is also very good source of beneficial bacteria. Another, in northeast, if you go, there are selected like your spinach, various kind of probiotic food. So the probiotic foods help to enrich our that microbiome bacteria. Another is environment. Definitely, if your environment is safe, your your inherent gut microbiota composition. If you are always face any bad atmosphere, definitely gradually that beneficial bacteria may whip out. Now that symbiosis, what is that? If your microbes are healthy, they are symbiosis, they happily do. They maintain your homeostasis, immune tolerance, and healthy metabolism. And they produce some of the chemical, they maintain the immunity through immune modification. Another is that they are not allowed to create any diarrhea or dysentery type of symptoms. And irritable bowel syndrome is also nowadays a very problem because our lifestyle. So when our gut microbiota will disturb this, when our gut microbiota disturb, it creates dysbiosis. This is dysbiosis. And what is happening? As a result, that immune-related disease is a problem. And some of the cases, intestinal disease, that inflammatory bowel syndrome, colon cancer. So now you can imagine, if we make good healthy habit, we can avoid our colon cancer related problem. And you, interestingly, if you look, just look back, why dietary fiber prevent our colon cancer? Actually, gut microbiota, they eat dietary fiber and they release some of the short chain fatty acid. That help to prevent any inflammation related process inside the intestine. As a result, no colon cancer, the possibility of colon cancer will reduce. Another problem is that diabetes and obesity. Why? Because you may think that in your surrounding there are some people, they are very healthy, they are working, still they have diabetes. Because of that diabetes, it may be related to gut microbiota dysbiosis. Because maybe they are healthy, but their gut microbiota change a lot. As a result, they are facing problem like metabolic disease, like diabetes and obesity. So now, how we can link probiotic with vegetables? Just I told that for survival of your bacteria, you need some food, and that is called some specific fiber, that is prebiotics. Actually, prebiotic is that very simple word, the food for probiotics. There are two major classifications, that is food to oligosaccharide or raffinosaccharide. Two kind of prebiotics there, which are very short in very low molecular prebiotics. And they mostly found that FO is mostly found in Asteraceae family, which are not very common in India. But it also available in Amaryllidaceae family, that is onion, garlic. So in our Indian condition, our product is very good because we generally take onion as a everyday diet. Onion, spring garlic. This is the spring garlic. It is mostly observed that North Indian belt like this that is spring garlic. And green onion also contain the spring onion. This is spring onion. They are also healthy and they rich source of fructose oligosaccharide. So these type of food we should take every day in our diet. So if we take this type of food, so definitely it increases your bacterial survivability, and as a result that your probiotic homeostasis can be maintained. Another is raffinose oligosaccharide. There are some source, but same as like Amaryllidaceae and Asteraceae family. However, some of food like broccoli, kale, they also contain a few quantity of ROF or raffinose oligosaccharides. Another thing is that resistant starch. They are not short chain, but they are very long, big size, molecular, macromolecular size fiber. But they are also food for your probiotics. Now we are coming the some of the good source of resistant starch, if you see in our India, that green banana, kacha kela, jo, you see the North Indian diet, East Indian diet, people have a very good thing that some of the Bengal, it is called jhol, but some of the soup like structure, and they are, we must use the green banana. They are very good source of resistant starch, so it help to boost our immunity, not boost, it maintain our immunity and intestinal health. And Indian, another food what I observe in northern belt, that is Sinara, that water chestnut. ICRCR regional center Darbhanga, they are working very well, and they are developing already high yielding some of the water chestnut variety, and definitely red color, and very peculiar things that they develop thornless water chestnut variety that may feature for as a source of resistance. Found in India, the Sindhi people. The Sindhi people, they mostly like the lotus. This is the lotus root. They are
We are having a little bit of technical issues. Please be patient.
Kole sir has joined us again.
So they, in our Indian, this two crops, this mostly actually, this is trapa, but it is, this is different, and it is mostly produced in China. And this is water chestnut also. Yeah, these crops very rarely in a northeast part some people has grow. And edible bamboo, that water bamboo, not edible bamboo, that is water bamboo. They are also a good source of this resistance. Among common vegetables, the pumpkin is very good source. In some of the paper, this paper is telling that pumpkin is good source for this resistance stack. India have lot of scope, because Indian all of the institute have very good kind of germplasm, and we can screen pumpkin genotype for source of resistance stack, and we can prepare very good pumpkin flour. I have seen many time people won't get very good price from pumpkin cultivation, but in if you go outside our country, some people some country produce huge quantity of pumpkin powder. Pumpkin powder is there, pumpkin seed oil also in steroid product. But however, the pumpkin powder is relevant to our lecture, and pumpkin powder is good source of resistance. So we can hide our product, that pumpkin starch. So here, cook our most of the aquatic food, aquatic vegetables, they are very good source of resistance starch. So when we sell our product, when we sell our vegetables as tagging this nutritional quality, what will happen? Immediately the value of the vegetable will increase. And definitely it has pandemic related benefit, because if you say your resistance rich food in market, telling that it directly with your immunity, definitely people in the hearing the word immunity, they will purchase. As happening for other, I have seen many e-commerce sites, they are highlighting foods as immune booster. Although I told there is no concept for immune booster, immune maintaining. Now, till now we have discussed many things, but now that what is my area of expertise, that is phenolics. I am working for more 10 years in phenolics. So initially I thought there are a lot of intervention phenolics compound, but till now we not found any phenolics intervention. And because it is a life-threatening disease, so we can't take risk. But some of the proposed mechanism, they tell that okay, they have phenolics have some of the role, like particularly that cytokine storm can be reduced, because phenolics have that kind of capacity. And interestingly, one of the paper I found very, very good thing for maintain and cope up the COVID condition. Our government tell that you stay inside the home. So what is happening? Definitely it is a physical activity. It social interaction also will be reduced and adequate rest also improves. So when physical activity reduces, adequate rest is there, it lead to some of the other problem like your own again, your mental condition be disbalanced. Another thing, alcoholism, that it may create problem of alcohol. It increase the alcohol consumption. Also some of the state like Bihar, where alcohol is prohibited, but many cases where it is not prohibited, there is a problem. So in this state, what to do? So we need some changing our behavior like that. Not only you, if you take only fruits and vegetables, immunity, it will prevent not like that. With that, we need some modification our lifestyle. Like fruit, vegetable, we should take enough quantities. Green side is that high quantity fruits and vegetable, water, herbal infusion. I personally observe that that Osimum Sanctum based herbal infusion really gives some stress relief, and I don't find some many literature there how it affect immunity, but we feel satisfied with the herbal infusion. So another is a problem that because in some of the literature they are telling that your protein should be there, but you must remember when you go for red meat, it again increase the inflammation. So try to reduce, not to take too much red meat, rather than as a protein source you take the protein from legume and white protein like fish and seafood. Another is that fish, seafood, all people can't take this. And another thing is that try to take whole grain, because I have told that dietary fiber have very good role, and whole grain, particularly in our Indian cultivation condition, people are well equipped with one thing, that sprouted moong or sprouted Bengal gram. They are a good source of vitamins, particularly vitamin C. And because we are not hitting the sprouted thing, so we can get thermolabile vitamin as such. No, there is no loss of vitamins. So we can, like this way, we can take some of the whole grain. Another thing, what should be prohibited? Not to take too much fatty product. Fat is not good, because fat increase the inflammation. And another thing that I not told earlier, I have studied that vitamin D3, generally what happens, this is active form directly got absorbed inside the adipose tissue. So who are fatty, who are they have problem that they may face some calcium related problem in their lifestyle, because your fat body after taking the vitamin D, as a result your calcium metabolism may hamper. So try to take low fat during this time, because of your inadequate rest and physical inactivity. It again, additionally, it increase your weight. It create some problem. Another is that, okay, you reduce intake of other calorie. Try to take lean meat or potato, but very so quality. Another is that most important thing is sweet. Although it sounds sweet, but it is not good for your health. This condition, sweet kill you. Actually, sweet even healthy, for healthy persons also, sweet is very dangerous, because sugar compound, it increase the chances of inflammation. So try to avoid sweet this type this time. And more and more that natural food, natural thing, high fiber food try to take. And this lead to, I think, another important I have studied. Now we have found that your vegetables have many role in immunity. But another problem is that COVID and psychological stress. Definitely, I personally feel during the first lockdown, there was a continuous lockdown. I was staying inside home. I have people on only phone. Even in the small children, they're still doing class online. So this is a one kind of psychological stress inside our health, and it creates anxiety, sleep disturbance, although now reduced, but many people still are facing this type of problem. Like us who have regular income, they can afford this problem, but there are some economic disturbances in our society. People are facing so much problem. Why people are getting suicide? Because after death of their spouse, some people are getting so much depressed, they're taking suicide, or some people are facing, how my income will be assured. So this unique condition create one sleep disturbance and anxiety. And therefore, we explore where the possibility of why we can start some vegetable which can maintain our anxiety. We have found that some of the food which contain or promote serotonin or melatonin synthesis. Serotonin or melatonin kya hai? Is that actually basically these are the neurotransmitter. They act as a neurotransmitter and they maintain your neuropsychological balance in our health. And most of the depression is related to serotonin. And for this, what we are usually, they are doing receptor uptake inhibitor. But here, if we artificially, naturally, if we give serotonin to our food, it gives better for our health. Fortunately, this is unique chemical compound. Although it first developed, identified in animal, later stage we found in some plant, particularly Brassicaceae, Cucurbitaceae, Fabaceae, Asteraceae. These are the plant family, very specific to this plant family. They produce serotonin. How this serotonin is produced? It is because of it acts the precursor molecule is tryptophan, one of the amino acid, and this tryptophan directly produce serotonin inside the vegetable only. But some of the crop do not produce serotonin. Instead of, they have only tryptophan. And if you consume tryptophan in our body can even also synthesis serotonin. Here tryptophan rich food are also there, potato, pumpkin, soybean, other legume. A lot of what is going on, and you see that neurotransmitter containing vegetable. I have searched some of the brassica rapa, a good source of serotonin, and tomato also some of the paper they are telling, this paper telling that tomato is very good source of serotonin. So we can think of that tomato, taking tomato. And another is that tryptophan, whether we can take tryptophan as the precursor molecule. And tryptophan is mostly that the higher content is available, potato, smashed potato, you can take. Potato is very good food, and also potato content resistant starch. I not mentioned earlier, potato content resistant starch. So it also helped indirectly help to maintain your microbiome, and tryptophan as a precursor molecule. And one unique thing that you may know that charmag or magajdana, all these seeds, cucumber seeds, they are very good source of tryptophan. And this is that vegetable soybean, they are a good source of tryptophan. So you can take. Now, till now, we have discussed, but what the implication of this presentation? That as a, when we look as a consumer, from this thing we can learn that okay, this kind of vegetable we should take, And along with this vegetable, we should not take like this. Like for gin, should not take with calcium oxalate rich vegetables. So because it will bind and it will make biofilm. So what kind of vegetables take? Who along combination of vegetables take? Combination fruits and vegetables. How we can the consumer? If we look at as a entrepreneur. We can think, okay, I sell my vegetable as a immuno maintaining compound. Selling your vegetables as a nutrition source. Okay, resistant starch rich vegetables, vitamin C rich vegetable, zinc rich vegetables. So there will be tagging for a consumer. Student, they can think they, one side they consume, another side they can get very good. Article from this, they can think review article. Another, those who are pursuing research, they can think, okay, we can do that first profiling of the crops, and then if a breeder is there, breeder can think, okay, I am doing research on the cucumber. I will increase vitamin C in cucumber. This is my target for next 10 years. So these are the importance of this topic in this present context, and in future we have to do many things. From this pandemic gives lot of chance to work for future, because this pandemic is a unique chance and we give the unique atmosphere. So in future, if any second pandemic comes after that, so we must be prepared for this, and we must be must know how to maintain our health, because nowadays it is very clear that this all the metabolic diseases like your obesity, diabetes, all are linked with nutrition. So our lifestyle, nutrition, we can regulate, we can moderate, and so for this in future, go for nutrient profiling in details. It's sophisticated instrument that they are also as India. Some people are not able to finding because of lacking of facility, but there are people there at least Bihar Agriculture University, they have very good lab, they are working hard, and most of the their breeder, I know personally them, Sirin Akhtar and Solanki and other people, they are very good. From initial day, but the during their PhD research, they most of their thrust was their nutrition profiling of the diet. So they have already started earlier. They have told to me that, sir, I will do like this. So this is the nutrient profiling and nutrigenomics that is essential. And in future, I think most of the researchers who are presently observing they will think, and government will also come, they will support this kind of study, because in our country, this loss of health, the loss of 60,000 or 70,000 people is a huge deal, because many of the intelligent people we lost. So it is a loss of genetic, knowledge erosion of our society. So we have to stop this wisdom erosion. You better to call wisdom erosion. We are losing our wisdom people. So we have to stop that, and for that, we have to invest investment in research in future, particularly nutrition research. So how we can make our 130 crore people happy and nutritionally sound? Another thing is that explore the artificial intelligence for new activities, because now artificial intelligence tools are coming. So we can identify there are many compounds inside the vegetable we don't know. So we have to find is that using in silico method, and lot of methods are there, and we can find how we can link. That is a food consortium. In future, we have to, from this understanding, from this pandemic understanding, different kind of nutrition we combine with a specific food or specific vegetable. Like we understand bioavailability increase with vitamin C. So if we develop a vegetable which have higher zinc and vitamin C, so this kind of food consortia, it helps for future scope, and definitely it helps for our sustainable health. And this is my today's lecture. Thank you. If you have any question, you can ask me now.
Dr. Kole, thank you very much. Thank you very much for your excellent presentation. Sir, you made us aware about the mode of action of the different vitamins and minerals and their immunity boosting mechanisms also. So you explained very well the importance of the different vegetables for boosting our immunity, and also you gave us insight about what food we should consume to make us to combat the stresses and also the COVID situation that is present now. Indeed, we need to make some changes in our lifestyle for combating the diseases and the stresses that we are encountering every day nowadays. And sir, definitely our aim will be developing vegetables with enhanced nutritive value. Definitely that is the aim of the leaders, sir. And sir, we have some interaction. We would like to have some interaction. Sir, Dr. Anil Kumar was there. He raised his hand. Dr. Anil Kumar.
Yes.
Yes, please unmute yourself, Dr. Anil Kumar. I think we are having some technical issues. Sir, we have another question, sir, for you. That is, sir, as you are working on phenols for a long time, sir. So phenols, as we know, are related to also some quality, sir, which is not exactly preferred, like in brinjal, phenols bring the darkness and all. So, sir, what will be our aim to increase the phenols or decrease the phenols? Because phenols are also important for countering the stresses of the vegetable, disease and pests of the vegetables also. So our aim should be increasing the phenols or decreasing the phenols.
Right question, Sirin. Very interesting why I studied some of the genotyping during IIBF. And during that time, I go through some of the literature. Very interestingly, they mentioned during our modern breeding approach, we unknowingly erode our valuable nutrition during our breeding. Actually, when we go for human selection, what will happen to tomato or brinjal? For tomato, we gradually give emphasis on lycopene. As a result, what happened? We never focus on other character, which may be linked with other pigments. So what happened? We lost some of the non-visible nutritional compound from tomato. As a result, modern day, which some of the variety may be very good, high, very red pigment, but it may not contain very good type of compound. Similarly, brinjal, for brinjal, what happened? You are right. For our nature, the breeder always cut the fruit and see whether is a browning, because phenol is essential for browning polyphenol oxidase. So people cut and see, okay, there is no browning, so it is desired character. Along with that, what will happen? Brinjal is some compound like chlorogenic acid is very most of the important and caffeinic acid and. Some of the other compound also there. So mostly people thrust on white color inside or brighter pink color or brighter purple color outside. So as a result, natural selection, we lose many compound inside. Get to what I thought it is better. We have to maintain a balance because the phenol estimation is very easy. So you first do that total phenol, you count that, but always try to keep a level up to certain level. Below that, below that, if you allow, what will happen? It acts as a defense mechanism of plant. So definitely that borer infestation may will increase. So better to study first thing, identify the line which are resistant to borer or tolerant to borer, and go for detailed profiling and found what is the nature of that fruit, whether it have the specific nutraceutical content is defined or not, what is the fiber nature, many things. Then you go with making a standard and make a balance with taste. Another side is your...
Sir, may I interrupt, sir? Sir, what should be the level? What should be the level to which we can go?
There is no such compulsory limit or level. There is no guideline. But the first thing that you have to go for first sensory, because visibility is a totally unhealthy practice, because ginger, when a consumer buy, he first not cut and take, okay, why inside is
exactly, then you exactly.
He buy based on outer surface. So a breeder should not think the inside color of the brinjal. Rather, outside color is very much important, not inside color. Another thing, because we generally cut and cook. So really, if brinjal after cutting, if it brown, what will happen? Nothing will happen, because we are going to add it as a, any food. So first decide our objective should be clear, whether which purpose we are doing. That purpose we should solve, and we another consideration should be there, that whether it gives too much astringency, too much sensory part. Because another vegetable skin problem, what is that? We generally do not do sensory after cooking. We do sensory of vegetables before cooking. We take 30 or 50 genotype, and before cooking we take the record. It is better, always suggested, if possible, it is cumbersome, but if possible, if you have good student, go for all genotype, go for frying or baking, anything. Then take sensory of everyone. Then you can understand what is the actually happening. That will be better for you. Another brinjal, another observation I remember, during 2011, I studied 30 jampalagam. When I was cutting the brinjal, some of the brinjal gives that antibody antigen, same type of thing, because brinjal has some kind of protein, and if it, some of the species, some of the variety have specific protein. And when you interact with your skin surface, your T cell or B cell will interact, and it gives irritation. That is your that what problem? That some people are sensitive to brinjal.
Okay. Yes, sir. Allergy some, problems occur.
Yeah, what is allergy? It is a peculiar antigen antibody system. So it is better. That time I, because I am not good, I just studied the quality, but that time my guide told that better identify which is not giving irritation, which is giving irritation. Separate those and go for it. Because this type of brinjal have very good personal food. If you are sensitive to allergy, for them make some brinjal variety. So it gives, I think in India nobody have done till. This type of thinking, you must come with this type of thinking, and you can release one variety that those food sensitive to brinjal allergy, they can get benefit for that.
Well, sir, we have another question. What should be the RDA of anthocyanin or phenols in human body? Is there any proven study or record?
Regarding RDA, recommending daily intake, you must know two things very important. What is essential and what is beneficial nutrient. Vitamins, minerals, they are essential. They are the cofactor of our various important pathway of our life system. So, it absence create lot of problem our health. That's why for vitamins and minerals, we have some diet intake restriction or limit or dietary intake level. But anthocyanin and phenols, they are secondary metabolites. They are not primary important nutrient. They are secondary metabolites. They produce by plant for defensive mechanism. It is a coexistent compound. When if animal or animal or human they ingested it had some beneficial load, not essential load. Even without phenolics and anthocyanin, we can sustain for long time. So it is not essential. That's why it do not have any kind of RDI. But generally told, we should take a sufficient quantity of fruits, vegetable, colored vegetable, fruits and vegetables. In colored content, anthocyanin, even phenolics have also colored. And earlier, what was for vegetable, it was 300. Nowadays, people reduce because our many understanding of nutrition. Now you're 200, 300, overall 400 fruits and vegetables. If you take daily, you can get that. And another thing, remember, it is not like that supplement. If you take 1 milligram of anthocyanin, it gives better health. Don't think like that. It is a very complex process. If you take wholesome, it is like a wholesome approach. If you take red anthocyanin rich fruits, it gives better result compared to if you take purified form of anthocyanin from that fruit. So there is no such kind of RDI or ADA.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your excellent deliberation, your excellent explanation also, and for showing us the way what our lifestyle should be for combating stress in our lives. We are all stressed nowadays for work from home and for everything. And the COVID situation, the pandemic has made it worse. So thank you, sir, for showing us some path about how to boost up our immunity and how to boost up our health. Thank you, sir. We have had excellent presentations. And now we have one announcement to make. And for that, there's one announcement that the chairman of our department, Dr. Randhir Kumar, will be making this announcement. Sir, kindly. Dr. Randhir Kumar.